tells you, if you could have dinner with any celebrity, dead or alive, who would it be and why?
If I could have dinner with any celebrity, who would it be and why? Oh, this is a good one. Does the politician count? Are celebrities?
Celebrity.
Oh, come on. James White is here and oh. That's right here.
It's negotiable.
Well, yeah, there are a few contestants we had sitting in the back.
That's true.
You talk about legs. We will show you some burned legs.
The judges that are sitting out here judging.
Well, you know, we'll get to the judges here in just a little bit, and we'll get them introduced to you. One I know very well, and I see Judge McCulley, he's paying close attention to my guy. You know, we're going to get to the question right quick. Wow, and you know, this is a good question. It's a good one. I think it'll fit her well. What are the best qualities a parent can share with their children? What is the best qualities a parent can share with their children? And I'm not sure who this young lady is up front that's laughing so much, but anyway, I'll turn it over to you.
One of the best qualities that a parent could share with their children is probably not to dress up like I have today. But it is in all good spirit and good charity when we join together in such a good endeavor to raise money. And I want to teach all the children of the world and all the children of Tyler County that we need to work together. We need to work together, folks. Fair question. How about this,
Kevin, with that? Hey, Donald. I like how you get vocal with the crowd. Or you don't have any chance to preach anytime, do you?
Occasionally.
Oh, and ladies and gentlemen, again, we apologize. This contest was supposed to be for non you know, he said he loved the summer. Right guard? Okay, yeah. The left guard got me. The left guard. You know, when you came out, I realize the black cowboy hat. I know when you're leaving, but there's a gym. Oh, yeah, the one that you just took off. Oh, man. I tell you what, he is a big, good-looking man. We could be. But he has hair, but also he does carry a gun also. So you do need to remember that, okay, Cassandra? You're looking lovely tonight. Lovely tonight. How about the question? You think you're ready for the question?
He's already won, so, but you've got to do the question. What? There's nothing wrong with that. I mean, he's confident. He's confident. She is confident. She is confident. I'd rather be faced than trying to win. That's much better.
What has been the most significant accomplishment in your life and why? What has been the most significant accomplishment in your life and why?
Look at that pedicure that she has.
Was that done locally here in town? Yeah, good business here we have? Hey, you probably pick up Stevie's book there at my house. Yeah. Oh, yeah, sure. Is somebody on the ground? Oh. Why don't you stand up for everybody when they see you? You stand up, take a bow. Take a bow, say thank you for the feet. You know, it is a good time, you know, on that note, it's great just to be sure and thank all the family who's been very supportive with the efforts tonight. Again, like I said, we couldn't do it without you. These lovely ladies could not do it without you. So, again, thank you.
Can you say that they're here tonight? I know they're here tonight to help support Relay for Life, but is it also because they didn't get a date for the prom tonight?
You know, that's true. That's true. The prom is tonight.
Oh, your date is out here waiting. You're going to go with
it. Date's out there waiting.
All right, are we ready for number 7's question?
Yes.
We are ready. This simple one. Tell me about a recent goal you have accomplished. Tell me about a goal you recently accomplished.
Recent goal that I recently accomplished was between around about January 2013. It came about January 1st, 2013, when I was told by the newly sheriff that I still had a job. The reason that was my goal is because I knew my wife would run the office. That was my reason and goal.
And she's done a great job.
Great job. You're Romeo.
Oh, I'm Romeo. Yeah.
Juliet.
Are you?
Yes, sir. And I'm looking out over my pasture. And you tap in the camera. Okay? Kind of setting the scene here. Okay.
Setting a scene here.
Are you ready?
Well, I'm ready. Let's do this.
Sure.
Nah, probably not. Go ahead.
Oh, Romeo. Romeo. Where are you? Romeo! Forget about your papa and the McCoy name. Dang it. You won't? Then swear you love me. And I forget about being a Hatfield.
Should I listen? Or should I speak?
It's just the McCoy name that I don't like. Call it what you will. But a hawk was just another thing. I do have a date for the prom. He's sitting out in the stand there. His name is Daniel Spivey.
Where is Daniel? Daniel?
Oh, come on,
Daniel's a former winner of this contest. Am I correct?
Oh, I don't know about that, but
I can tell. She's a winner. She's a winner. She's a winner.
You're welcome. You're gonna keep your dress down tonight?
Pardon?
Are you gonna keep your dress down tonight? All right, your job with those stairs is gonna cover the kids' eyes.
Yeah.
What about now?
There you go.
I'm gonna be on a serious note right now. I know I can't top what the first other contestant in front of me done, for sure. But I wanna speak about somebody that I knew that had breast cancer and that was real close to me. She was my grandmother. Her name was Molly Marshall. My grandmother, we had a nickname for her. It was called Little Granny because she was probably worth about 4'8", 4'9". And she was born in January 16th of 1913. And throughout the time, she was kind of ornery. You know, she had her favorite grandkids and everything. I wasn't one of them, of course. Then in 1999, she found out she had breast cancer. And she had to go for the treatments and everything. And by 2000, she was in remission. Although she had to take a handful of pills every day and to help her. But then I noticed as she was going through remission, she made a change. At first, she wouldn't have nothing to do with my kids, which was her great-grandkids. And then all of a sudden, you know, I think the Lord finally showed her which way to go. And she started having more to do with the grandkids and great-grandkids. And I can remember when she wore the little rags on her head, I used to pick on her and tell her, "Look, I'm bald. Go ahead and take it off. We'll sit here and be bald together." While we played dominoes, she was 42. She gets so mad when she played her domino now, I thought she was going to tear my mom's table up. But she lived till 2011. She was 98 years old. And that's one of the reasons I don't mind doing this, because it's for a good cause. I know if we didn't have back then the research we had at that time, she wouldn't have lived as long as she did. And just tonight, when y'all decide to give a donation, just be sure y'all know what, I just want to let y'all know what y'all are giving it for. It's for a real good cause, because we don't know if your wife or your child's going to have breast cancer, but we want the best possible scientists and most money we can get to give more lives to the people that do have breast cancer. Thank you.